Hello, I'm Michael Glass from michaelglass.com, where we make informed decisions about our financial future. This is our Forex technical analysis video update. Before we begin our video, we always like to start off our disclosures. Any symbols that you see today should not be inferred as a trader recommendation. No matter what form of investing you choose, stock, forex, futures, option, they all have a level of risk associated with them. You can lose all of your money. Any strategies we show today are for informational purposes. Future results are not guaranteed. And finally, any investment decision you make is solely your own responsibility. Trade at your own risk. As we said, this is our Forex technical analysis video update. In each of our videos, we will review the prior session's price action to come up with key support and resistance price levels. We'll look at the crude and gold charts to come up with leading sentiment. We'll come up with a low volatility watch list, an inside bar watch list. And we'll have an economic calendar update to see what could affect our future and open trades. And finally, if there's time, we'll have an education spotlight at the end. Let's pull up the charts. As always, we are starting off with the gold daily chart, and we can see our little range that we're in. We did go up and make a double top. That's important to watch. We can say that there's sort of a M pattern going on here. So that's certainly watched. Notice that this last swing high here is where the buyers came in and found value. So we can see that range of about 1790 up to 1890, 100-point range. We also see that we are closing at the 20 moving average where we once before found support. Just like before, we broke through it. The buyers brought it back up. Buyers brought it back up here also. So it's going to be interesting to see how we go from here. Clearly, gold has been on a tear, and let's zoom out for one quick second. Take a look at the monthly chart, and we can kind of see that double top there. We can see how beautiful August was as far as the charting, and you can really see, forget about that 20 moving average, you can really see how beautiful this is right in here. So there's still plenty of pullback that can happen before we have to be concerned about the bulls. As we come over to our market profile, we can see pretty much a lot of consolidation. So there's not on these last couple days, there wasn't a big free fall. We did fall, accumulate, fall. So we have a lot of volume resistance on our way back up. It's not just going to be a straight shot back up to 1890 like it was on this day here, and we talked about that. If we got above here, we can shoot right on up because there was a lot of light volume in the past, and you can see that we just shot right up there. So if we can get out of this range here, you can see our first bullish area to look at would be. Really, 1850, but this little area that we're in right now, 1820, will run us into this volume accumulation of 1850. But you can see if we get above 1850, we do have one big candle that will run us up into around 1875. So that's what I'm going to be watching for the bulls. So with our gold pulling back, what does that mean for our currency pair? So we'll start off with the euro dollar. Here we can see once again our range is in place. We've had this in for you for a while, and we came right down, tested the 200 moving average, and we said that in this area, and we also tested the low of this range, and now we pushed off on Wednesday. We moved higher, and now we're going to see what's going to happen here. Are we going to come back and test this, or are we going to begin our track higher? We can see on our 1 hour time frame that we are below neutral, so we're in a buy zone, and we are below our long-term moving average. Again, another buying indication. We did move above our short moving average, which couldn't lead to a move higher, but we'll have to wait and see. Who's in control? Well, the euro is in control, but you can see as they converge, move towards each other, we're seeing the pullback a little bit. Hopefully, maybe we'll get a bounce off the moving average here and make a move higher. They're both beginning to swing high here, and that's why we're seeing a little pullback in the pair. So if the euro can keep control and perhaps swing up, we will see price action move higher. Our pound dollar, again, we had this in for you. Came down, tested a low, and we're putting in almost a falling three type pattern here. The buyers are defending 1.6, 1.59. Again, sort of a falling three chart pattern there, so it's going to be interesting. Notice that with today's pullback, or a little as we came down, we're starting to see, let me get the crosshairs for you. So here's our big push down, notice the volume, and then in our pullback, we obviously we pull back on our volume. So this is why we have an inside day, which we'll talk about. And so if we can break below here, that'll be a nice inside day break in the direction of the trend. But we're also in a buy zone because we're below neutral. We're also below our long-term moving average. Here we can see we did get a breakout, and then we're pulling back to the moving average. Why? Well, on this one, the dollar is in control. And each time the dollar diverges away from the pound, we get that big move. Got another divergence here. And then now the dollar is moving up. We're starting to get another divergence here. You can see the pound moving down a little bit. So we may see another move. But we can also see right now that we're possibly, just like we're seeing on the daily, we're starting to see this on the hourly, this potential support here in this 1.5 price level. 5.9, I'm sorry. So again, both of them are averaging lower. I'm sorry, the pound's averaging lower, the dollar's averaging higher, and it made a bounce off the moving average. So as long as the dollar's in control, we will move lower on the currency pair. Finally, we will move to the dollar franc, and look at that move. Look at that move. That's quite impressive. We went through a couple zones just in one day, and then now, so again, we got a little pullback, that rising three now. Are we ready to make a move to the 200 moving average? Well, we'll have to see, but clearly we are in a sell zone. We can see we're in a sell zone, well above our long-term moving average. The dollar is in control. We can see this big divergence here is this big move higher. Then we got a lot of parallel price action. So now we're getting a little divergence. If we get a divergence, then this will move higher. We can see the franc dropping off and averaging while the dollar moves higher and bounce. So as long as the dollar is in control, we will move higher and possibly make that run to the 200 moving average. As we move on to our watch list, we're going to start off with our low volatility watch list. This is our 1 hour time frame using Bollinger Bands, watching the high and low bands for that breakout. We have the pound dollar, the pound yen, the dollar franc, and the dollar yen. Those are our low volatility candidates. For our inside bar candidates, we're watching today's range as compared to yesterday, and we look for a break of that range, preferably in the direction of the trend. We're going to be watching the euro dollar, the euro yen, the dollar yen, and the pound dollar. As we move on to our education spotlight of our video, we talked about our fears of trading. We've talked about pulling the trigger. And now we get back to my favorite part, which is trading plans. You have to know where you're going in order to get there. And too many times, traders focus on trading, but they don't focus on what their goals. They don't focus on where they want to go. They just focus on, I've got to trade. And they lose money because they don't have a strategy that gets them to their goal. Heck, their strategies don't even work. So, you know, we spend a lot of time talking about making sure your trading system matches who you are as a trader. In order to do that, you have to be able to answer those questions about where you want to go, how much do you want to make, what vehicle are you going to use to get there. All of these things guide you towards becoming a profitable, high probability trader, and it increases your chances of being successful if you take the time to learn those basic things of what vehicle, how much we want to make daily, how much we want to make monthly, how much we want to make yearly. And therefore, we can strive to put together a plan, a trading plan, to accomplish those goals. You know you can find us on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. We have our saved resources. We have our free 5-video course on high probability trading, help you just figure out how to design your own high probability trading. This will give you an insight to who we are as coaches. We work with you one-on-one, help you develop that personal trading plan so that you can reach your goals as a trader. Get paid to trade, cash back for your forex trades. Doesn't change the conditions of the market, doesn't change your spreads, just rebates for your forex trades. And if you want singles, we have those too. We have a bunch of providers for you. Find the one that matches who you are as a trader. It can be traded automatically, or receive the singles and then trade them for yourself. But the most important thing is, it doesn't make a difference about the room, the signals, the indicator, if you can't pull the trigger. And we do that, we gain that confidence, we develop the trader's mindset by developing a trader's trading plan that matches where you are and where you want to go as a trader. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you next time.